poinsettias in honor of loved ones. If you'd like to have some poinsettias set out that you then will take after the Christmas Eve service, we'll print the names in the Christmas bulletin of all those we're remembering. And that our Christmas celebration is actually on the 22nd, and we will be celebrating. And in addition to our special music and message, we'll also have a potluck luncheon. Please bring friends and family. They're all welcome. And our Christmas Eve service will be at 7 p.m., so we invite you to come to that. And in the other room, you will see there's a sign-up sheet for an event in February, which is the Swedenborg's 332nd birthday, and the celebration is at the Boston Church. And it's, the speaker will be Dr. Devin Zuber from the Center of Swedenborgian Studies, so you can read the poster about that. There's also a suggestion box for sermon topics for 2020, looking for input from all of you, what you'd like to know more about. And we are collecting for the food pantry, which is across the street, and our basket runneth over. So if there's anyone who's available to take the collection across the street, we'll start anew. And then the last two things, we need a few more coffee hour refreshment volunteers for the new year. There's a sheet in there now through April. And all the books on the coffee hour, by the coffee station, on the bookshelf, those are free for Christmas presents. There's also a stack of angel books on the side table, and Ken has generously donated CDs of the meditations on the seven angels and Christmas CD. So if anyone would like to take those, thank you very much, Ken, for offering those for us. So let us begin with our first carol, which is number 184, and we're going to sing verses 1 and 3.
A child will be born to us, a son will be given to us. and the government will rest on his shoulders. And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. There will be no end to the increase of his government or of peace. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will accomplish this.
Please be seated. I'm missing the little people in the front row. But that's okay, we're all little people inside somewhere. I wanted to talk a little bit about how we bring the light with us. We each have a light inside of us, and we bring it with us wherever we go. Well, today I'm going to give you an actual little light to take with you wherever you go, a little tiny light. That a light can be a spark, can be just a small little spark of light. It can be a bonfire. A light coming into the world comes from a mysterious kind of process that you light a match and you, all of a sudden it comes into the world from the friction of the elements that make the light, or the electricity that turns the light on, or in this case, the C batteries. But light is mystery. We really are surrounded by it, we live in it, and yet do we know what it comes from? And what it ultimately comes from and what it corresponds to in us is it's the life that is in us. It brings us alive, and we shine with that. We shine with the light that goes out from us, from our eyes, from our understanding and our wisdom that we share with us, but also the light in us is where the warmth comes from, just like in a candle. It's where the light of life brings warmth and light into the world. And it allows us to grow, to see more light around us, to have one idea spark another idea. That light is something that grows when it's shared. So I'm going to pass around a little candle for everyone. The other thing a light is good for is looking at it and being still. How many people have sat still and looked at the light of the candle? Yeah. There's something very calming about that, isn't it? It's very calming to be still and look at the light. Because intuitively, I think we know that there's light in us. So the light that we're looking at is a reflection of the light in us. So I encourage you during this season of Advent to keep this handy. Maybe in your pocket or in your purse. And when you're having a stressful moment, think, I need to get back to the light. And have that light handy that you might take a still moment, even if it's just holding it in your hand, and let that light remind you of the light within that is always there because you are alive. If we weren't alive, we wouldn't have the light within us. And when we are alive, when we return to the light, whenever we need to go within, the stillness of just looking at the light and the mystery of the light and how it enlivens us is one of the things about this very holy season where we recognize the darkness that we may be in, but then we also reach for the light. We let the light guide us. And that's what we'll be talking about today, a little bit more about the story of Mary and Joseph and how they followed the light. So I have to leave a few in the front row for the kids when they come next week. They need to have light too. And the other thing that brings light, which is what I was hoping the children could share, is looking each other in the eye. You see the light in the other person. And you know when the light is even brighter? When you smile. Yeah, I see it. The light is brighter when you smile because your joy of living is being shared with others. So give people eye contact and give them a smile, and you'll be surprised how much light will come into your life. Amen. And we're going to light the Advent candles. Today, we don't have any kids to help us, so if anybody would like to come up and light the Advent candle with me. Today, we light the candle first and second Sundays of Advent, knowing we are that much closer to the special day that we celebrate Jesus' light coming into the world. Now would you please rise and we'll sing hymn number 162. Dear Lord, we give thanks for this day, for this coming away from our regular routines of busyness and involvement in the material world to just simply rest in this sanctuary of peace, a place of quiet where your voice can reach us. We come away because we know that our life is in you and for you. And with you. And we come to be strengthened in knowing the story of your birth, the story of you coming to live in a human way that you might more fully understand us and we might more fully know how to act in the truly human way that you have shown us. You've shown us love and compassion, protection and guidance. You listen to us and we come to you with the prayers of our hearts. As we lift up the names of those for whom we pray this morning and we ring a bell that that prayer might resonate into the heavens, and we ask that in addition to helping those we love, we ask that you help us to know how to be a better blessing in their lives. We pray this morning for Ava and Lily, for Desiree, for Ben, for Grace, for Nick, for Sage, for Ted, and I invite you to lift up the names of others who are on your hearts this morning.
McAtee family, the Schrager family, Brian Wilkowski.
Susan.
Rosario.
Lord, hear us now as we pray in the silence of our hearts. Dear Lord, in these prayers, as in all things, we ask that your divine will be done. Hear us now as we pray in the words that you've taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
These are ways in which God spoke to them and brought them miraculous news. And when we think about light as life, and that life as that came into the world was the life of God coming into the world, it came in through the baby Jesus, who was born a baby, lived a life, and he brought love into the light that we look for even today. It was a small thing to be given this message from the angel, but it evolved into the greatest birth of all mankind, because none of us can say the world has not changed because Jesus was in it. The religions that formed in his name and the way that all came about. But Mary and Joseph, let's get back to them. Regular people, I'd like to invite them to join us this morning. They lived a life in a village. They followed the Jewish rituals. They had families. They did work. They had neighbors. And they're just regular people who had an amazing experience. They were engaged to be wed. Now I'll take it from the scripture. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said,
Hail, thou art highly favored. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women.
And when she saw the angel, she was troubled at this saying, cast into mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her,
Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
Then Mary said unto the angel,
How shall this be, seeing I know not a man?
The angel answered and said unto her,
The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. For with God, nothing shall be impossible.
Then Mary said,
Here am I, the servant. servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word.
And then the angel departed from her.
To save me, the mother of
Joseph slept on it. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. And Joseph, her husband, being a righteous man, not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But when he thought on these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying,
Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For it is he that shall save his people from their sins. Now all this is come to pass, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son. And they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is being interpreted, God with us.
And Joseph arose from his sleep, and did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not, till she had brought forth a son, and he called his name Jesus. Beautiful song that we heard, the Magnificat, was composed and written by Lori Turley. This miraculous story, which we recount and reenact and read each year, is one of darkness into light, of coming from a dark place in the world, which it was when Jesus was born. A place where love was not expressed as freely and as openly. It was a world of laws and Roman rule. But through the story of Mary and Joseph, we see how their light shines more brightly when this angel comes to each of them. How they suddenly change the course of their lives through following this message from the angels. Trusting that these were messengers from heaven and that it was an important part of the world's journey for them to have this journey together. But there was another light in that scenario that I want to just lift up today. And that is they saw in each other, in each other's eyes, they saw the light of their important combined energies to be parents to this baby. They relied on each other to make it safely to the baby's birth. And as they saw and heard angels throughout, they followed the call. We know that after Jesus was born, Joseph received another dream to take the baby safely out of Bethlehem into Egypt. But they loved one another and they loved their child. They didn't know what would come. We have the blessing of hindsight. We know the story and how it goes on. But for Mary and Joseph, it was following the light of the Lord without knowing what would happen. Following God's light to raise Jesus to manhood. And in accepting this as their path, they became lights themselves. Mother Mary is revered by many, and she's often called upon in times of darkness. I'd like to read for you a reading from a book called Watch for the Light. And this is by Isaac Pennington. And he's referring to this verse in John. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. And this is from Isaac Pennington. What is the darkness that comprehendeth not the light? Is it not man in the unregenerate state? Ye were darkness, saith the apostle, speaking concerning them as they had been in that state. Now it pleaseth the Lord that in this darkness his pure light should shine, to gather man out of the darkness For unless light should shine on man in his dark state, he could never be gathered out of it. But he that is turned to the light and followeth cannot abide in darkness, but cometh into that which gathereth and preserveth the man mind out of it. But of what nature is this light which shineth in the man in his dark state? It is of a living nature. It is the light which flows from life. It is the light which hath life in it. It is the life of our Lord Jesus Christ, of the Word eternal, which is the light of men. And he who cometh to the true understanding may thereby distinguish it from all other lights whatsoever. There is a vast difference between it and the reason and understanding of a man. For the natural man with his understanding is dead. But this is living and operating powerfully in man, as it finds entrance and his mind is joined to it. He that is dead indeed knows it not, but he that is alive unto God feels the virtue of it. This light is above all gathered knowledge and above all descriptions whatsoever, for it is of the nature of him from whom it flows. In other words, it's a mystery. We are called out of the darkness in this season of Advent. We are called to look to the lights around us. I know many of us have lights in our homes, and it is the darkening season when the nights are long, and the light that we are looking to that externally brightens our homes and our lives is a correspondence to the light within us. The light within us that is our life, but also that is the engagement with our faith and with the Lord that brings the light from inside of us, outside of us, into our relationships with others, through our eye contact, through our smile, through our ability to care for one another. This is the light of Christ that is in each person, and we are called anew every season to come into a greater connection with that light. Whether it's sitting still and looking at that little candle on your hand and just being quiet, the Lord is waiting for us to hear what we need to hear. We are very often too busy in this season to hear the voice of the Lord, which is why our sign out front says, slow down. Slow down is what we all need to be able to accept that the Lord is always there waiting to fill us with more light and life, more energy for serving one another so that we might love one another as he has loved us, which is to fulfill the greatest commandment. Let's all take a moment to simply feel the light of God. Know that it is in you. Know that it is all the good that you were inspired to do. And with God's help and God's peace, we are called to become a new person, a new version of ourselves, more fully engaged with the Lord's blessing, the Lord's guidance, and the Lord's protection. Amen. Enjoy some quiet music while we take our offering for the work of the church. Thank you.
May the Lord keep our going out and our coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen. And for our closing song is number 59.